Welcome students. Today we will discuss about computing in C++, the programming part of your syllabus. In this we will see chapter 5, review in C++. As you already know, C++ is a programming language. It is a high level programming language. In programming languages there are machine language is there, assembly language is there, high level language is there. C++ is a high level language. Now we'll see C++ was first developed by Bjarne Stotter at Bell Laboratories. It is in New Jersey. In the 1980s he developed this programming language. It is a object oriented programming language. Object oriented programming means it is a programming paradigm. Paradigm means it is a methodology in which we are solving the problem, the way in which we are solving any problem, or the style by using which we are solving that problem, that we call it as a paradigm. So OOPs also a programming paradigm or methodology in which objects and classes are used to design programs. The OOPs contains the main concepts and characteristics. We already discussed in last class. Just we will see a review of this. The main concepts come in OOPs are object, class, inheritance, abstraction, polymorphism, encapsulation. These are the main concepts, or we can say characteristics of the OOPs. Let's see one by one. Review we'll see. Object is nothing but it is a real world entity. Real world means anything we will see in our real world, that is the real world entity. For example, mobile is there, that is one real world entity. Mobile car is there, chair is there. Like if you see living things, dog, cat, or in plants, anything in real world what we are seeing, that is the real world entity, that should have some attributes and functionalities. Attributes and functionalities, if you have some attributes, or we can say the properties and behaviors, then we call it as the object. For example, if you say the mobile is a real world entity. It has the properties or features like that every mobile has one name is there, model is there, and for that price is there. These are the attributes of that mobile. And functionalities mean what are the function performed by the mobile. We can make a voice call, we can make a we can send a message, we can make a video call, we can play the video, we can play the audio. These are the functionalities of that object. So it is a real world entity. That object is nothing but a real world entity. It should consists of attributes and functionalities. Then we say that is one object. The attributes and functionalities we say in C++, data members and member function, because in OOPs concept data is the main element. We call this as the data members and member functions. So next we will see the class. Class is nothing but it is a collection of objects, or it is a template of objects. We also say it is a blueprint using which we are creating the new objects. By using one class, we can create n number of objects. So we can say object is the instance of the class. So by using the class only we are creating the objects. So object is the instance of the class, and class is the template or blueprint using which we are creating the object. For example, if we say we can say car is one object, car is one class. By using this class we can create n number of objects. MWA car, that is one object, RD car, that is one object. If you say other real world things, fruit is one class, it has some properties. By using that fruit we can create n number of objects. That apple is one object of that fruit class, orange, grapes, like that. These are the examples for class and objects. Clear? this is about the class and object. Every class, in the class only we are defining the data members and member function, that is attributes and functionalities of the objects we are defining in the class. So we can say class is a structure in which we are defining the attributes and functionalities of the object. This is about class and objects. Next, inheritance. Inheritance is nothing but it is the acquiring or using the properties of the another class. One object using the characteristics or properties of the another class, we say the inheritance here. Inheritance, the class which providing, which allowing to use the characteristics or properties of that, that class we say as the base class. Also we say parent class. And the class which using the properties, acquiring the properties of the base class, we say that as derived class, or we say child class. This is inheritance. In inheritance there are many number of inheritance are there, which we already discussed in last class. Single inheritance, multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hybrid inheritance, like that so many types are there. Next, abstraction. Abstraction is nothing but it is the we can say hiding the implementation details and showing the only essential parts. That process we call it as the abstraction. Polymorphism means poly means many, morphism means forms. The same function we are using in many forms. Single function is there, the same thing we are using in the multiple forms, many forms. That we say as the polymorphism. Example for polymorphism is function overloading, operator overloading. These are the examples polymorphism which we are using in OOPS concept. Encapsulation is nothing but binding the data, that is the attributes and functions of the object, the data member and member functions, both are combining into a single unit called class. That is encapsulation. This is the OOPS concept. We already discussed all these things in our last class. Just I review this, revise the basic concept of this OOPS. Now we will go for our fundamentals of C++. In C++, before we learn, for example, if you want to learn any language, in general English, Kannada, any language if you want to learn, at that time what is the process before start learn? First thing, we should know the letters. We should know letters, what are the letters in that language. Next, by using that letters we are making the words, we are creating the words. Next, by using these words we are writing the sentence. And finally, by using sentence we can write the paragraph, story, we can write the essay, like that. We are learn the any language, first we should know the letters. By using letters we are making words, by using words we are creating the sentence, finally we write the story or essay writing, anything like that. Same thing in C++ also, first we should know the character set, character set of the C++ language. And by using these character set we are creating the tokens, we are making the tokens. These tokens, by using these tokens only we are writing the programs. Finally, we can develop softwares, we can develop web applications, like that. Clear? This is the flow, like that. Character set is nothing but like the letters. If we say that in English language, first we should know the ABCD. By using ABCD, we are creating the words. Like that, in C++ also, character set is there first. Now we will see first character set. Character set in C++, mainly three character sets are there. First, alphabets, numbers, and special characters. Alphabets is it contains both the uppercase and lowercase letters, A to Z, all the letters, both uppercase and lowercase, or alphabets comes in the character set of the C++. Clear? Next, numbers. All the numbers from 0 to 9 we are using in the character set of the C++. Special characters, other than this alphabets and numbers, all the letters come in special characters, plus, minus, brackets, flower bracket, and equal symbol. Yeah, all the letters, dollar symbol, and symbol, not symbol, all come in the special character. Understand? This is about the character set. In character set, three things will come: alphabets, numbers, and special characters. Alphabets contains both uppercase and lowercase letters. Numbers contains all the 0 to 9, all the numbers. Special characters contains, except other than these alphabets and numbers, all are special characters. Clear? This is about character set. Now we will see the token. Token is nothing but it is the smallest unit in the program. We also say this as the lexical unit. Smallest unit means this is the basic thing we are writing. And we also say this is the most fundamental element. Fundamental element means by using these tokens only, we are writing the code of the program. We are writing the programs. We are developing the software. So, tokens are the most fundamental elements. By using these elements, we can write the statements. We can define the variables. We can define the functions. We can declare the variables. We can declare the functions. We can write the complete function code. Finally, at last, what happened? By using these tokens only, we are writing all the programs. Clear? So, token is, it is a most fundamental element using which we are constructing or writing the statement, definition, declarations, and so on. We are writing. Clear? Now, we'll see what are the tokens come in the C++ programming. In C++, first, identifiers are there. Next, keywords, constants, punctuators, operators. These are the tokens we are using in token in C++ programming language. Identifiers, keywords, constants, punctuators, operators. Now we will see it one by one. What are these? First, we will go for identifiers. Identifier is nothing but it is a name given to the programming element. In programming, while writing the program, any element, it may be smallest element, anything which we are using, for that we are giving one name. That name we say as identifier. Such as variables, arrays, functions we are writing. For those we are giving name. That is nothing but identifier here. This identifier contains letters, digit, and underscore symbol. Clear? It contains letters, digits, and underscore symbols. Letters means all the letters, uppercase and lowercase letters. Digits, all the digits. In special characters, it use only underscore we are using to write the identifier. Clear? And in main thing in identifier is it always start with letter or underscore. It will not start with digits. Remember this point. Identifiers are always start with letters or underscore. It will not start with digit. Second letter, third letter, later we can use, in between we can use the digits. But starting letter will be always it is a letter or underscore. And in C++, it is the case sensitive. So, uppercase letters and lowercase letters are differently treated here. For example, if you see here, student, it is one identifier. We are giving one name. It may be a variable, it may be an array, it may be a function, anything. Student. Here below, student is there. It is small. We are written using lowercase letters. This student we are written using uppercase letter. So both are two different identifiers. Both are not same in C++. Both are different. Likewise here, amount. See, starting with underscore. It will not start with number. It may be start with underscore or letter. This amount with small lowercase letters and amount with uppercase letter. Both are different. Clear? Both are treated as two different identifiers in C++. Likewise, we can use the numbers also. Marks 1, rank 5, anything we can write by using letter, digit and underscore. We can write any word. We can give any name as an identifier to a variable or array like that. Clear? You should remember it contains letter, digit and underscore only, and always start with underscore or letter, and both uppercase and lowercase letter treated as two different element, two different identifier in C++. Clear about identifiers? Now let's see for another token, that is keyword. Keyword is nothing but, we can say it is also a identifier, but it is a predefined identifier. Predefined word means in C++ certain words are already defined, already created, defined. For that, for every word, that predefined word, it has some special meaning. Compiler know that the special meaning. Clear? Keyword is a predefined word that gives special meaning to the compiler. For example, if we say if is there, if it is a keyword that is already defined in C++. So that keyword, it has some meaning to while writing the program. It is for check the condition, we are using that if keyword. Clear? Like that int is there, char is there. These are all the examples, while, bool, case, break, like that. There are some keywords are there which are the predefined words. They are some special meaning, and we cannot use these keywords as our own identifiers. For example, take int. Int is a keyword that is already defined in. We cannot use this int as a identifier, normal identifier. We cannot give int as a name to a variable, other thing, because it is a keyword. Understand? These are the reserved words. We cannot use that. Clear? This is about the keyword. Keyword is a predefined word that gives special meaning to the compiler. These are the reserved words we should not use as a normal identifier. Next, we will go for constants. We also say this as literals, constants or literals. Constant is nothing but, as the name say, constant. It is constant. That is, during the execution of the program, the value of that cannot be changed. It is always fixed. It is a fixed value that we say as the constant. For example, 5, one number is there. Throughout the program, through the execution of the program, the value of 5 is 5 only. It cannot be changed. Like that, some tokens are there. Though it is one token, those value is fixed during the execution of the program. That cannot be changed. There are so many constants are there. Let's see one by one. Integer constant, unsigned constant, floating point constant, character constant, string constant. These are the 5 types of constants are there in C++. Clear? Constant is nothing but, it is a fixed value, cannot be changed during the execution of the program. And you see, it is also identifier only. Means it is an identifier whose value is fixed. Let's we will see one by one what are these constants. First we will see integer constant. Integer means, as you know, integer means the numbers with both positive and negative values, and it should not contain any fractions, no exponents, only numbers, both positive numbers and negative numbers we can use here. That is integer. Integer constant is a number that do not have any fractional part or exponent part. We are using both positive and negative numbers. Integers always begin with a digit, or it may contain plus symbol or minus symbol. Plus mean it is a positive number, positive integer. Minus is it is a negative integer. Clear? Integer is a number which contains both positive and negative numbers. There is no fractional parts here, no exponent parts. And we can specify integer constant in all the number systems, that is decimal, octal, hexadecimal, all the forms we are using in C++ as an integer constant. Clear? Next, we will go for unsigned constant. Unsigned constant means it is nothing but these are the only positive numbers. Some situations in program, somewhere we are using only positive number, no need to use negative numbers. At that time, instead of using integer constants, we are using unsigned constant, because this is because to represent the that constant, that values, because there is the limit is there, the index limit is there to define any variable, any identifier, anything. If it is it cannot be exceed, it cannot be overflow that index limit. So for integer constant, the limit is there. If we are using unsigned constant, when we want to use only positive numbers, when we want higher length of that, during the execution, during writing the program, we will know complete about this, how we are using that unsigned number, what is the length of that integer constant or unsigned constant, we will see. Just you understand, unsigned constant is nothing but these are the positive numbers. For example, I am telling, when you are writing any program, writing any student details, number of students means number of students always a positive number. We cannot give number of students are minus 10 like that. It may be a 0 or more than 0. So it is always a positive number. In such types, where we use only positive numbers, we are using this unsigned number. Unsigned number is nothing but it is a only positive numbers, no negative values here. Clear? Next, we'll go for floating point constant. Floating point constant is nothing but which contains the decimal points. You know, floating point, decimal point is there. In that, two parts are there. One is fraction part is there. One number, real part is there. Fraction part is there. That is floating point constant. We also say these constant as real constants. Clear? Real constant. These values contains decimal points, or it may contains exponent part also. Clear? Floating point is nothing but the values which contain decimal points or exponents, that we call it as the floating point constants. That is, it contains the fractional part. They can be represented in two forms. In floating point constants, we can represent in two forms. One is fractional form, another is exponent form. Fraction form is, it contains like simple 35.05, 124.9, like that. It contains fraction parts. Exponent form means there is the form like this, 23.49E0. Here E is the exponent part. After E, whatever you are writing here, it is the exponent part. For example, see, for this example, you can see 23.49E0 means here, if you write in other format, like this, 23.49 into 10 to the power of 0. It comes in the power digits are there here. Clear? E0 means 10 to the power of 0. E1 means 10 to the power of 1. Likewise, E5 means 10 to the power of 5. This is exponent form. We cannot, while writing the program, we cannot write the powers in the program. So for that, we are using this exponent form. Compiler can understand E0 means it understand 10 to the power of 0. If you are writing E10 means, compiler automatically understand that it is nothing but 10 to the power of 10 like that. It understand this is the floating point constant. Clear about this? Floating points contain two forms, fractional form and exponent form. Fractional form only contain the decimal point, that fraction part. Exponent form means it contains the power of the digits. Like that, it contains the E number. E means it means exponent form. Now, next we will see the character constant. If you not understand now while writing the program, you will understand the concept. If you confuse here, don't worry. While writing the program, at that time I will explain once again how it will come, how we are using like that. Now we will see character constant. Character means it is a single letter, single character, which we are enclosed within a single quotation. Pair of a single quotation. If you are right in the pair of single quotation, then we say this as a character constant. Character constant means it contains only one letter. One letter. One letter we will say as a character that we write in the single quotation. And the value of that character constant which cannot be changed during the execution, we say that as the character constant. For example, A. See here, you can see here A we are writing within the single quotation. P we are writing within the single quotation like that. Yeah, it may not be only letters, it may contain number also. See, 5 we are writing single quotation. If you write within the single quotation, then it is not a number here, it is a character. We can see compiler consider this as a character constant. It is not a number, it is not a integer. If we write same 5 without the single quotation, it is considered as a integer constant. If you write with single quotation, it considered as a character constant. Clear about character constant? Now we will see the string constant. String is nothing but it is same thing, we are writing in double quotation. The identifier which we are written in the double quotation, then we say this as a string. String may be a, it contains zero or more characters. Zero also, or it may contain more than zero. 1, 2, 3, 10, like that. We also say this as the array of the character, because string is nothing but it contains the letters only. Letters are numbers. Those, every letter is a character here. So we say it is a array of the character. Clear? Here if it is the, when we are writing the string, by default what happen, compiler automatically in last it adds a null character. It adds this null character which we represent like this slash zero. If we write, this is nothing but this is the null character. This is very useful to understand the length of the string or end of the string. While writing the program, you understand this concept, why we are using this null character. Clear? By default, compiler adds a special character that we call it as a null character at the end of the string. This means it is the end of the string. If when we are checking that, if null is came, null means this is the end of the string. After that, there is no string is there. Clear? Null character. We also represent if there is no characters in that. That means only null character is there. For example, I will show you here. For example, we are writing only double quotation like this. Only double quotation. Within this, we are written any character, not a number, not a character. Only this means this is the null string. We call this as the null string. Understand? Here only null character is added here. Clear? For example, like this college. You can see here college. We are written within the double quotation. This is a string constant. Color. We are written within double quotation. This is a string constant. Here C++ programming, we are written, this is the string constant. Clear? String constant, these are the constants mean which cannot be changed the value. We cannot change the value during the execution time. Value is fixed. That is, if we are written only double quotation, no letter or no number, this is the null string. Remember this, null string means it is a string which has zero characters, no characters in that. Now we'll go for next, punctuator. Punctuator is nothing but these are the some symbols which having some meaning. A compiler can understand that meaning when writing that program. for that there is a special meaning is that where we are writing that depending on that the value will be changed. But they do not specify a value for that. They perform any operation by default. When we are writing the program, the value will be automatically changed. The punctuator means nothing but some special symbols, special characters. Those are the punctuator. Example, not value, not symbol is there, percentage symbol is there, and symbol is there, star, like that. These are the special symbols we are using as the punctuator. While write the program, you will understand this. Clear? What are these punctuators when we are using these things? Clear? Punctuators. Next, we will go for operator. Operator is nothing but we are using operator for perform the mathematical problems. To solve the mathematical problems or any logical problems, we are using the operator. As you know already, mathematical problems, addition, subtraction, multiplication, these are the operations. Like that, to perform any mathematical operations, we are using operator. These operators tell the compiler to perform a particular operation, particular mathematical operation or any logical manipulation, a compiler should understand by knowing that operator. In operators, there are so many operators are there. We classified as unary operator, binary operator, and ternary operator. There are three types of operators in C++: unary, binary, ternary operator. Let's we'll see one by one. Unary operator. Unary means single. Unary means single. In this, what happened? This operator contains only one operand. Operand, you know, operand means, for example, in general, what happened? There are two or three variables will be there. Operands are there. For example, I am writing here A plus B. You can see here A plus B. This is one mathematical expression which contains the operator. Here plus is the operator, A and B are the operand. We call this as operand. A is one operand, B is operand. Unary operator means which contains only one operand. Only one operand it contains. The unary operators are, these are the operators: not, and, negation, star, plus plus, minus minus. These are the unary operators. For example, I will say you here. Example, you can see A plus plus. Here plus plus is the unary operator, A is the operand, only one operand. This means plus plus we are using to increment the value. A plus plus means the value of A is incremented one value will be for example, if A value is 5, means if we are using A plus plus, the value of A will be changed to 6. If the likewise, minus minus is used to decrement. It is a decrement operator. We are using to decrease the value. For example, B is equal to, for example, I am writing here, B value will be 4. 4 is the B value. If you are writing minus minus B, this is we are writing. After executing this, the value of B will be 3. We are decremented the value by 1. One value will be decremented. Like that, A plus plus means incremented the value 1. A, if A value is 10, then once we execute this A plus plus, after that A value become 11. Clear? Unary operator means which contains only one operand. The operation will be performed on only one operand. Example, these plus, and these are the example, plus plus, minus minus. These we are using in our C programming. At that time you will understand these operations, how these unary operators will be used. Clear? Next we will go for binary operator. Binary operator, binary means two operands. In this, two operands will be there. It operate on two operands. In binary operators, there are so many operators are there. We will see arithmetic operator, relational operator, logical operator, assignment operator, bitwise operator. These are the operators we comes in binary operator. Binary means the operator which operate on two operands. Let's we will see one by one what are these operators. Let's first we will see arithmetic operator. Arithmetic means you know arithmetic operation, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These are the arithmetic operators. The operators are arithmetic operators are plus, minus, into, divide, divided by, percentage. These are the arithmetic operation. You know generally arithmetic operation for addition we are using plus, subtraction, minus, like that. These are the arithmetic operations. These perform the arithmetic expressions. By using these operator we are used to write the arithmetic expression. Next we will see relational operator. Relational operator means the operators which we are using to know the or compare the two operands or know the relation between the two operands. Relation means the operators are equal, equal, not equal, greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. These are the operators, relational operators we are using. Why we are using equal, equal to? We are using to check the value of A is equal to A another value or not. For example, you can say here A is equal to A is equal to B. Here we are checking value of A is equal to B or not. We are checking here. A is equal to B means value of A is equal to B. Like that, value of A is greater than, we are checking, greater than B or less than B. Like that, to know the relation or comparing the two operands, we are using these relational operators. Clear about? Relational operators are used to perform the relational operations like equal or less than, greater than. These are the relational operations. Clear? The result, when we perform these relational operators, the result is always it will be 0 or 1, that is true or false. For example, here we are checking A is equal to B. If we perform these operations, it means A, value of A is equal to B. If it is equal to B, then value will be 1. If it is not equal to B, the value will be 0. Like that, answer will be, it will be 0 or 1. It is true or false. Clear? Next, we will see logical operators. Logical operators means these are used to perform some logic operation. The logical operators are and, not, and, or, not. These are the logical operators. You will see when we are using these logical operations. We can say these are the compound operations also. When we are using compound operations, at that time we are using these logical operators. The result of these logical operators also true or false, that is 0 or 1. Clear? Next we will see binary operators. Next assignment operator. Assignment operator is nothing but this we are using to assign the value to a variable. Assignment operator is equal. The syntax is variable is equal to, we are giving value or expression like that. For example, you can see here n is equal to 10. Here we are assigning the value 10 to the variable n. Here sum is equal to n plus 35 means we are assigning the value of this n plus 35 to the sum. Here first what happened, 35 will be add to n, the result will be assigned to sum. Here equal we are using to assign. You just don't confuse here between double equal. If you are using double equal means it is a relational operator, we are checking equal, comparing that. Single equal means it is assigning the value. Clear? assignment operator. Single equal means assigning the value. Double equal means comparing it is equal or not. That is assignment operator. Next we will see bitwise operator. Bitwise operator means bit means as the name suggests, this operates on bits. The bitwise operators are and, or, these are the left shift, right shift. These are the bitwise operators. While writing the program, I will explain you how we are using these operators. Clear? Bitwise operator works on bits. Bitwise operators are, these are the operators. Clear? Next, we will see the shorthand operator. Shorthand operators means by combining bitwise operator and assignment operator, we are writing some expressions. Those are the shorthand operators. Combining both assignment operator and arithmetic operator. And we are writing expressions. Clear? For example, if you see plus is equal to, minus is equal to, into is equal to, these are the shorthand operators. How we are using? See, for example, generally what happen if you write a is equal to a plus 4. Here what happened, the value 4 is added to value of a, then the result is complete result added to a. Here for example, if a value is 3 in beginning, after executing this what happened, 3, a value is 3, 3 plus 4 7, 7 is assigning to a, the value of a becomes 7. Same thing, instead of writing this, we are writing in shorthand. A plus is equal to 4. This means the value of 4 is first added to 4 added to value of A. Then again, the final result will be added to the A. This means this is equal to A plus like this. Instead of this, we are writing in shorthand. These are the shorthand operators like this. Same thing we are write for minus, multiplication, like that. Wherever we required, we use this one. Clear about this? This is about the shorthand operators, that is binary operators. Next we will see the ternary operators. In ternary operators, means nothing but which operates on three or more operands. More than two operands, these operators are performed. The ternary operator, also we call it as conditional operator, because it is the alternate for the if else statement. The ternary, this question mark is the ternary operator. This is question mark, it is an example for ternary operator. This is the alternate of if else statement. When we are knowing that if else statement, at the time we will know that how we are using this ternary operator. Clear? This is about the operators in C++. Today we will discuss character sets. In character set, all alphabets are there, numbers are there, and special characters are there. Next we will see the tokens. In token, what are the different tokens are there, and we discuss about the tokens. What is identifier, what is keyword, what is constant, what is punctuator, and what is operator, and in that what are the different operators. All these things we discuss in this class. Next we will see in next class. If you have any doubt, you can ask me.